One of the things that we chose to do in the pandemic at the end of the school year was to create a virtual choir. And I know a lot of people did it, but my kids had had enough experience sending me videos and things like that for our online projects that we started, again, long before the pandemic hit us, that a virtual choir was not hard for them. It was hard for me. And there was a learning curve, but it was worth it. And so the first thing I did was I sent them recording instructions for our graduation virtual choir, because in our district, they had little mini graduations in each of the auditoriums where about 15 students would get to walk across the stage and get their diploma and have their families clap and take pictures. And it was 4 days of graduation ceremonies. It was a lot, but we wanted the students to have a real graduation experience and knew that we couldn't have a choir or band or orchestra or something like that be a part of it, and it needed to be a virtual experience. So the first thing I did was I sent out recording instructions to my students after, of course, researching virtual choirs that other people had been brave to attempt before I was. And so I told them what the equipment they would needed, how they would need to practice. There were solo lines in ours, and so I wanted to make sure that the soloists knew this is the part that you had to sing and this is what you had to do, and that you couldn't be late for entrances and you had to count your cutoffs and things like that. And then I told them what they needed to do for the recording and how to dress, that the background should be as uniform as possible, which you will see when I show little clips that not every student was exactly able to follow that particular rule. And then to try to be good performers about it and to submit it all to me through Google Drive. And then I got all of these things, and again, being separated from my students, just seeing each one of these kids do this was so good for my soul. I don't know if it was as good for them as it was for me, but it was something that we were able to share. And so I had to spend many hours, also with the help of my husband, who is much smarter than I on computer technology. And it took a long time. The longest time, frankly, was creating the audio, because bless my children's heart, they didn't always cut off when they should have. And so I had to kind of go through and switch the audio a little and use different technology for that. And so I was able to do that, and we created a virtual choir of You Will Be Found from from Evan Hansen. And so I'm just going to give you a little taste. And being able to do this was worth all of the heartache of putting it together, because it was about 16 hours.
Have you ever felt like nobody was there? Have you ever felt forgotten in the middle of nowhere? Have you ever felt like you could disappear, like you could fall and no one would hear? So let that lonely feeling wash away, 'cause maybe there's a reason to believe you'll be okay. 'Cause when you don't feel
So all this technology that I've been doing for 5 years brought me to the steps where I could do something like that. And I'll admit that I don't want to have to do it every year because it was really hard work. But at the same time, I gave my students and my students gave me hope and healing in a time when we all needed it. And so I hope that you'll take the chance to be brave. I spend time in the summers learning my technology because I don't have time during the school year. I teach, I take care of an autistic son, and I don't have time for anything else. And so I do. I spend a couple of hours every day in the summer learning new technology, and it has been worth it every step of the way. Thanks.